Hello and welcome to this YouTube tutorial where I previously showed you in the first tutorial how to install Grunt. In this tutorial I'm going to be showing you how to prepare yourself for a new Grunt project. I kind of already built the foundation in the previous tutorial by, you know, installing Grunt and creating our package.json and our Grunt file.js. But what I wanted to show you is just kind of how Grunt runs. And in the previous tutorial, we installed Grunt. So as you can see, Grunt's in here with its node modules, Grunt, JSON, node unit, and these are the ones that we, you know, had in our package.json file and uglifies in there. Basically, in our package.json file, let me open that up. You can see we've got our dependencies and what we wanted to install. We can actually put other things in here. So I have a default project where I kind of run each time when, you know, I'm, I don't know, creating a project. So as you can see in this particular one, I've got Grunt obviously installed. I've got CSS min. So this again is a different, another package that we can install using Grunt. I've got JS hint, sass, uglify, watch, all these particular, you know, packages that we want to install. And when we do actually run the package installation manager, it will install these for us. I don't want to install them right now, or we'll do that in another tutorial, but you can see how I'll show you how these like differ from one another. Going off the screen there. But as you can see, I've got the one on the right, what I use by default, and the one on the left. And let me pull these up. As you can see, the node modules are different upon installation of these packages in Grunt. And when we're just updating packages, it'll obviously create the folders and put anything else it needs to do in there. So we've got Grunt on the left, what we just previously done. And on the right, we have the Grunt projects from my default implementation. So we've got obviously everything what's listed in here under dev dependencies. On the left, we've got all the dev dependencies that we installed whilst installing Grunt. And if we put more in there whilst installing Grunt, obviously all those particular packages would download as well. So that's kind of how the package.json file works, and this is my basic, this is the Grunt file.js that we installed previously, but I'll show you how my default Grunt file looks. So in here we are obviously putting together our initial configuration, reading in the package manager that we want as our dependencies and our plugins. And then we're just loading in particular specific plugins. And here again, we're loading the tasks throughout the dependencies. So yeah, that's kind of it. I would prepare a new Grunt project. We start by installing Grunt, then we'll run obviously the Grunt commands, but anything that's installed within the package.json will be pulled into the node modules. So yeah, very simple. If you don't have any questions on this, just drop a comment below and I'll do my best to help. But again, the package.json file is used by the node package manager to store data, to be more specific, metadata for the for our projects and whatever particular dependencies that we need for our development. So yeah, that's kind of everything in terms of a new project. If you haven't installed Grunt, go back and, you know, watch the tutorial on how to install Grunt. It's very simple. It's three or four lines of terminal commands, and just make sure you have your package and your Grunt file already ready, so when you're installing Grunt, it'll work perfectly. The grunt.js file basically is just used to configure our defined tasks, specific tasks, default tasks, and load our Grunt plugins. But yeah, that's it. Make sure that the Grunt file.js and the package.json are in the root of your project. And yeah, they should be committed and kept safe when running your Grunt projects. If you're running an older or using someone else's project from an existing project, to make sure to change the project's root, obviously, within the configurations. Install all the dependencies, because you probably don't have them installed. So I know a lot of people, when using Git or some source control management, they don't install or capture all the node modules, which could be CSS main, JS hint, sass, all these type of things. So make sure you update and bring your node packages up to whatever you have listed in your package.json, make sure, because if you using someone else's version, it may not work with the particular version that you've downloaded. But yeah, that's it. If you do run Grunt again, it'll give you a, oh, we don't have a default configuration, because we don't in here. But I don't seem to run on my default configuration file any default implementation, but I kind of just go with, look, I want to run Grunt CSS main, run that for me, you know, minify all my CSS files. But yeah, that's kind of how you set up a Grunt dependency project. Again, if you do have any questions, because people and myself may be quite new to Grunt, I've been using it for a few months now, really useful, speeds up development, and I don't know if I could create a project without Grunt, to be honest. But yeah, thanks for watching. I think in the next tutorial we're going to be minifying CSS files with Grunt, and the tutorial after that I'm going to do JS files. And then as we get on later on to future tutorials, I'll be going over the watch task and concatenating with Grunt. But yeah, once again, thanks for watching this tutorial. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below or tweet me at Carl Hadwin, and I'll do my best to reply. Catch you guys in the next video.